welcome. Dos. How are you?
Oh, welcome in. Welcome in.
How you doing today?
I'm good. How are you?
Good.
Good to have you.
I'm just going to look over here.
Okay.
Have you done an interview before?
A few, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
For call related things? Or for
no, never for that. Never for that. Just stuff. I was on the news once. I saw an accident. So they had to, like, get my take on it.
Yes, come on in. Watch your step here.
All right.
Can you just
We're very excited to have you.
Oh, thank you.
Almost 10 years. It's interesting. You know, I am the longest holding member in the cult.
Wow.
Yeah.
I know it's a little messy in here, but it's, you know, you can't contain genius.
This is two pairs of clothing. Okay, we've got two shirts, a nice shirt on the outside, and then a nice comfortable shirt on the inside. I've got my athleisure shorts over some, you know, a little more business shorts underneath. It's just kind of, you know, finding symmetry and everything. Two pairs of clothes, just try to keep everything too.
Yeah. So I wake up and I make coffee.
Twice
I
into
make
the
about
symmetry
eight
the
cups,
twice into the
and
world.
That's kind of just the standard. It's divisible by the two, but if I don't want eight cups, I don't have to drink them all. Maybe I can just drink two cups. It's just, I'm not.
Twoism, as we call it, the tenets of twoism, the two commandments, are everything is two, and there must always be two. As in, there is symmetry in everywhere. Look, everything you experience can be divided into two equal parts, and we think that this represents the ultimate symmetry that is at war with asymmetry in the world. It's a relationship of order versus chaos, and this is the easiest way to order the order against the chaos.
You have three buttons on your shirt.
Split?
Your shirt has three buttons on it. No, the inside one.
Wow. What was my life like before the Cult of Two? I don't think about that often. I actually don't really, I've disassociated from that previous identity. Yeah. I mean, I've always been Peter Kalnassus. People called me Pete, Peter, Petey, PP. Didn't like that one. But I do think I found myself, you know, in this community. So everything before that just doesn't really matter to me. I'm a barista. I make coffee. Yeah. I try to make myself of service to the community around me, and through this, I try to spread the word of symmetry, you know.
Does that ever get in the way, like, Cult of Two, you making a drink?
Yeah, like, if someone wants three shots in their Americano, I will put a fourth.
Well, there are five lights in the bathroom.
Okay, but I've had to make up a lot of my own meaning for this, you know, along the way, because there's no roadmap. That's what I learned. There's no manual for how to do this, you know. It's just a voice inside you that tells you what to do.
What do you want me to do today? What do you want me to do today?
No, he's not here. He's not here. I think there's three of you. Following that voice, I have come to learn that I play a very important role in keeping a balance in this duoverse, you know, in this reality, in this existence. I very much enjoy music. Lots of Bach, lots of fugues, okay? Lots of canon. A lot of that is symmetrical, a lot of that pre-Enlightenment period, Baroque era, you know. I like Mozart, you know, but I block out the 3-4 parts. No waltz, I don't really find it enjoyable, you know. It's like listening to music in 3-4 is like walking with a limp, you know. You know, when the rhythmic meter and the key are symmetrical, I find that the frequencies interact with who I am just in a much more pleasant way.
Do you feel it? It's inside.
Do I listen to jazz? No. What does my family think of the cult of two? A lot of them don't know. I'm very good at keeping secrets.
Peter's terrible at keeping secrets. He tells everyone about the cult.
My wife, who's asleep in the other room, doesn't even know you're here right now. She doesn't know what I do. She doesn't know that I am the leader of probably this eon's most important spiritual transcendence. There are a few family members that have found out, and so when you come to these contemptuous moments with family members who say they care about you, but really they don't because they don't actually understand what it is you're doing, you just have to deal with them how you deal with them.
You only have one toothpaste?
Well, I ran out. I had to go to the store. So, it's okay, though, because one can be divisible by two if you really think about it. You know, there's duality in everything. Can you... Just don't say stuff like that. Don't point it out, because I know. You know, There's a duality in everything, even in an unduality. There's a duality.
I'm not afraid of the word cult. You can call us a cult. Cult is counterculture, you know, because cult is the root word of culture. You know, it's just a group of people doing their own traditions. Cults can be bad things. Cults are tools, you know, and in the wrong hands, it becomes something very toxic. But when you don't have as many hands, say just two pairs, it becomes something very personal, very, you know, benign, a family. You know, I like a tight community.
Pete? You ready to film?
Yeah. Just tell me, you weren't rolling on that, were you?
I loved The Cult of Two. It was like phenomenal to even be able to express myself, you know, like so openly with just one other person. But Peter was like enjoyable, funny, made me laugh, made me smile, made me cry, a shoulder to lean on, a movie to watch was just him, you know? We didn't need television. We didn't need any of those things. We had, just had Peter.
It scares me. Like I said, I don't really remember who I was before the cult. And so life after the cult, I don't think that exists for me. I think others have done it. It makes me sad when I see them. I pity them. I feel above them. You know, I know that's not great to say in our current society, but I do feel like I've been chosen to be the tool of symmetry. And that's why I keep getting chosen. And life after the cult, hopefully that life is in heaven, in that second plane, yeah. In a religious partner and just a partner in general, I like obedience. right? If someone has their own ideas, that's okay. But there is a set of rules, right? A set of traditions. You can put your own twist on them, but it doesn't really work unless you do what I say.
This is our bi-weekly two ritual.
It's the twos.
This is where the magic happens. You guys are going to see it.
Mike's a good guy. Mike's good. He has yet a ways to come, but the seed for potential is there. You know, I think of myself as a gardener, and here's my garden. I plow a seed, or is that the phrase? I don't know. I've never actually gardened.
Candles, and I got the bread. Nice. Wonderful, wonderful bread.
Thank you.
This will be fun to split in two. A good divisive bread. Or dividing, divisive, divide, able to divide.
Divisionable bread.
That's right.
Divisionable.
And do you have the candle holders? Alabaster. We're giving Mike more responsibility in the cult now. We have a, as a community, as a duo, decided that, you know, Mike will, he's going to provide more things for the experience. I'm excited.
The holders?
For the candles, yeah. Well, that was part of your responsibility, was to provide some things. That's okay. Hey, you brought two. If you brought candle holders, it would have been three.
Thanks for understanding. Yeah, no, do you have them?
You don't have to do that. You can just talk.
I'm just embarrassed.
Embarrassed, buddy. Yeah, I've got candle holders. I've got the backups. They're a little off theme, but that's okay.
Sorry, it's my first time. I've done the ceremony before, but
it's okay.
It's like we're in paradise.
You could say that. Or yeah. We're heading to paradise. We're hoping to transcend to paradise.
I'm 5'6", 220 pounds. I wear an XL t-shirt. My foot size is 9.5. I do have to wear orthotics, because my...
We're actually wondering about, like, think about your past, or what you do for fun.
Oh, sure. Sorry. It's a little nervous.
Yes, yes, yes. How does this...
It's probably changed a good bit. I know it changed a lot from, you know, my generation, you know, like when it started. Rituals are a little different. They, you know, it's a whisper down the lanes type setup, and who the hell knows what they're doing now.
Doing. Doing. Okay.
Alright.
Dos. Dos.
Thank you, duo. Who watches over the dual verse, what many perceive as the universe, which is actually dual with your two eyes and your two spirits, the yin and the yang of existence, who look at us, down upon us, hoping to transcend, hoping that we shall transcend as much as we hope to transcend. It is today in our bi-weekly ritual, duo, that we light these candles for you.
Dos.
Dos.
Who would my ideal partner be? I couldn't imagine doing this without Pete, you know? I mean, he... One and two, two and one together. I mean, technically, yes, there's like a possibility that I can move on without Pete, but I mean, he's like the chosen one. He's told me that he's the chosen one. I mean, yeah, sure. Like, if I could have, the bagel guy that I go to on Wednesdays. Okay, his name is Steven. Steven, he uses his family's recipe. He's from New York. Yeah, he moved here about 5 years ago. And it's my Wednesday treat. I get an egg everything bagel with egg, cheese, bacon, and then Steven makes his own hot sauce. So he went to You know Anthony Bourdain? I mean, I work with food. I am a bike courier, but like cooking.
It seems like it really.
It's just fun to make stuff for people, you know? Like, making people feel seen and, like, sharing something. Like, I love the breaking of the bread. I think it's such a cool thing. I wish we had more people to break the bread with. You know?
You wish the cult was had more people in it?
I didn't say that I wish that we had more people. I'm just saying it would be nice to...
Brother Mike. Yeah, Brother Mike. This is great success. Four. That's. Look at the break. Show them. Show them the break. Oh, Brother Mike. It's perfect. It's perfect.
Thank you.
We will have a good 2 weeks.
One for you and one for me. 1 + 1 = 2.
Dos. And now this next part, we like to smoke.
Okay, just let me give me. Now, so cults have been around since the beginning of time. It's nothing new. It's not even original. It's probably the most derivative thing there is. Now, if you look over to my left, there's actually a man, a child. And I point that out because families are actually the original cult. They're more or less just a cult that you kind of didn't ask to get into, and you can't really get out of. Over here's a tree. Now, the most current members of the Cult of Two, I don't know super well, but one of them is named Peter, and one is named Mike.
Well, Pete and I grew up in the same cul-de-sac.
Mm-hmm.
There was one time that, when we were 9, Pete and his sister threw, like, this huge, like, cannonball contest.
Mike told us about a pool party about his kids.
Oh, the pool party. One instance where Peter tried to drown me.
And I won. I do what I call the flying eagle. So I perched on top of the cabana. And then I fully spread out.
Peter tried to exclude me from my own life by ending it.
And then...
At the last second, he turned back into a cannonball.
It was huge.
I'm kind of the brains. I do, like, the planning, and, like, the writing, and, like, the fundraising, and, like, the organizing, and, like, the recruiting, and, like, the budgeting, and, like, the feeding, and, like, the trend setting. I kind of do all of it.
And I'd say, like, I'm good. I'm nice to look at. Something that I know that this guy doesn't know?
Nothing. Probably nothing.
I know that Deborah loved you. I think you struggled with that for a while.
Because I couldn't tell. She would say it. She would say, I love you, Pete. And I'd be like, do you? Mom?
I'm a bike courier. That's my job. When I feel like it, and it's not a great time for bike couriers. Like, you really gotta ride your bike a lot, and it's hot out. So for fun, I like to read. Yeah.
Reading currently, what did you just
say? I read Don Quixote. What I like about Don Quixote is that it's just a really fascinating tale about somebody who gets to, like, have a passion and wants to do greater good for the world and for people, I think it's just really admirable. And it's funny. Like, I think so much in life, like, we don't allow ourselves to, like, be our authentic selves. I really like that he's able to, you know, be quirky and kind of be off, but ultimately his quirkiness is what saves people.
Is Pete the Don Quixote to you, Sancho?
I what are you trying to ask?
Do you see yourself more as a sidekick?
Do I see myself more as a sidekick?
You can speak freely here, Mike. You can say whatever you want.
Do I see myself as his sidekick? I, Michael Stefan Sanchez, feel that sometimes not everyone's story is being told.
Hey, Pete. Why don't we just take this mic, step out of the room?
Coffee is great, by the way. Best friend. Can I go pee real quick?
Yeah, go ahead.
Hey.
You guys keep doing the interview?
Yeah. Oh, today would be a great day to have a dog.
If you could see anybody in the second plane in the afterlife, who would it be?
Deborah.
Pete's mom.
She practically raised me. She was the prime example of...
Pete, please.
Of what it meant to just be a good human. And I don't think Pete ever understood that. My favorite thing about Pete... The Oxford Dictionary.
Now, cults fall apart all the time, whether it's internal strife or bickering. Sometimes the man just cracks down on him, you know. Or, you know, it could be anything. I mean, you know, everyone knows about drinking the Kool-Aid. They thought that they were reaching a higher power. I know with some of the cults I formed, we just got bored. Just got sick of it. It was kind of stupid.
I love this man. I mean...
I love this man.
He's my best friend.
Yeah. I am his best friend.
Thank you.
did in Fort Worth?
When I was still teaching at Brown, there was a young man who approached me. He was very nervous, very sweaty, and his name, he told me, was Terrence Fulworth. He told me he was a student, but then I said, if you're a student, what's with the badge? And he came clean with me right away. He was an FBI agent, and he came to me asking me about my expertise on cults.
Hey, you guys weren't followed, were you?
I don't think so.
Okay, cool, cool. You're not cops, right? You gotta tell me if you're cops.
We are not cops.
Cool, yeah. It's very dangerous. I mean, any cult within the U.S. Penal Code is considered automatically dangerous. That's just the way it is. You know, it's so extraordinarily dangerous that I usually have to, that's exactly why I keep, I'm sorry.
Are you missing something?
Yeah, did you guys see a gun lying around?
Government is full of a bunch of misguided...
Just don't drive out of here. I've run over it before.
Sick, toxicity, just vitriol.
And that's like 13 cultists. A 7-Eleven robbery isn't a cult. And the FBI would agree.
Do you not know what a cult is?
No, I know. That's my job. I know what
He refused. He refused me. He said, no, it's me. It's my show. I'm the guy. I'm going to infiltrate. You know, I'm a big, cool FBI guy. And I said, okay, well, here's some information. Good luck, pal.
Did you find it?
I'll just check my... Have you guys seen my car keys?
There is a community outside of the Cult of Two. There's a series of people who want to be a part of the cult.
My girlfriend's freaking obsessed with this one cult. Takes all the time, and I don't get to see her at all. Like, at all. So I thought, you know, I might join one myself, just so I'm busy as she is.
Well, we're not actually a cult, we're just a documentary.
Yeah.
When you leave the cult, you really do, you're forced to move on. You can still help, you can't ever put your name back in the hat again. So people try.
I almost went to the ritual, like, a couple years ago, but I was like, I didn't want to be, like, weird old dude hanging out, because technically I'm not supposed to put my name in and stuff.
Okay, you're only considered a cult if you're a threat. And if we're a threat, then that's fine.
It is one of the most dangerous cults in this country. Gloria, she meant a lot to me, and she got involved with the cult.
Do you know a past member named Gloria?
No.
Two wine glasses, and then what happens? The next day, two of our suitcases are gone. Gloria and Roger are gone, two people leaving the love of my life and my brother. That's what the cult took from me.
Yeah, I still have some, like, journals and stuff from it. One thing that was passed down that, like, I offered it to the people that were taking over, and they're like, we don't know what that is. So I had, like, it was like an old reel, like an old, like, film reel of, like, the original, like, cult folks. I had that, and I offered it to them, and they were like, we can't play this on anything. I said, okay, so I just kept it, but I had it digitized a few years ago. Do you want to link?
Hey, you guys.
Hey.
I'm running on film right now, and it's kind of expensive.
Buy some more.
Yeah. Are you going to reimburse me?
No!
I would love to tell you the history of the cult. It's a very great story. It started with two people back in 1974, Kyle Doris and Patricia Orbison. And now these two people, how they met is really up for debate. You know, some say it was random, some say it was an act of two.
So, Kyle and I were chilling one night, and we had a vision.
Collectively, we had a vision.
Yeah.
Out of this came a shared vision, okay? Two pigeons. two beautiful courier pigeons that had escaped the bounds of their homing training.
Two doves swirling around.
The other part of it, which I think has kept us relevant over the years, is that it's not always the same members, you know? People trade out, people are replaced.
Okay, yes, if we do a show of hands of who's gonna be the two of the cults, then the two people that get their hands up the fastest, they're the ones that get to be.
Tell us anything about the cult's history.
Did Pete say it's okay for us to talk about that?
He gave us a lot of information, so whatever you have, yeah.
Okay. What I know about the cult's history, not the Colts, not the Indianapolis Colts, which I can tell you a decent amount. Jim Irsay is a really wild owner for the team. He's had his own troubles with alcohol.
Really need to know about that.
Go! Now this week it's us, and this is awesome. I think this is like exactly the outcome that we were looking for. Like, it's strong. It's just like you can feel that strength.
I feel the energy. You know, the fact that I didn't expect this and now this has become my whole life and it's gonna be documented. This is insane.
We're thinking. Oh! Oh! Vision! Vision! Me too.
Vision!
Oh. Vision! Oh. Oh.
I can see two people.
What are you recount? You have to wait 2 years.
You gotta wait 2 years. You gotta wait.
You guys are teaching me a lot.
Tony Escondido, wow, what a legend. Came from a wealthy family, and she went on to form a very, very, very influential, very powerful cult that you might know as the Reagan administration.
About to head to a major establishment in the neighborhood to recruit people for the two. Basically, the process for getting recruitments is honestly being assertive, being aggressive about your human connection contact, going up to people directly, handing pamphlets out. Mike was good enough to print these out.
Yeah,
for the cult. Black cloaks are actually a staple in the cult of the two. People called it stupid at first, but you know, there's a lot of stupid things. So,
and sometimes if you don't want people to like, say you see somebody that's not in the cult that you know, but you don't necessarily need them to see you.
Mm-hmm.
Like if Pete's wife's around, you can. You can kind of do like a, yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's a deadbolt, Mike. It's a deadbolt. Just gotta say bye to the wife. Hey, babe. Huh? All right, I'm gonna head out.
Where are you going?
I'm meeting up with Mike.
Who?
Mike.
Huh?
Mike, I'm meeting up with. We're going to the bank. I'm gonna pick up this thing.
Okay, will you pick up some milk on the way home, please?
Yeah, 2%? Okay, 2%?
Yeah, it's fine.
Alright. Going, love you. I don't know when I'll be back. Probably like 2:00.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I don't know.
Okay.
All right.
Are you okay?
I'm okay. All right.
Okay.
Love you too.
She has no idea.
Do you wish life was simpler? Do you believe in the power of two? Do you?
1 + 1. Take a pamphlet. Hi. I'm sorry to bother you. Do you wish that life was simpler?
The power of two. It's the power of two. Like anything's divisible by two if you make it.
Jackson Ryan Hole.
Hole.
Are you confused?
Nope.
Oh, okay. Sorry, you're asking questions. I don't really understand what the cult is about. It kind of just sounds like a marriage to me, but I do enjoy the flyer, so I probably will go. Do you know if they're single?
The cultists?
Yes. Or are they married?
I believe they're, well, one of them is married.
One of them is married?
Yeah.
So one of them is single?
Yeah.
Okay. I've been approached before on two occasions, so I think I'm shopping around. I'd like to be involved in an organization.
I am here just shopping for a few things for my kids. I am a school teacher, third and fourth grade history. So I do a lot. I'm tired a little bit, but I'll do this. I did have one kid talk to me about how he choked on an enchilada and nobody helped him.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, and it was like 10 or 15 minutes before anyone really helped him. Yeah. Yeah. I think I'm gonna go. Is that crazy? I think just a little bit of community, you know? That's hard with such little people, but just maybe people who understand, you know, me or what I'm going through, what I need, because really very few people ask me that.
So what's the exact opposite of what an FBI agent is, right? FBI, we're working on land. We're solving mysteries, we're solving crimes, right? Where don't you solve mysteries and crimes? The sea. I'm dressing up as a sailor. I'm coming in with a pipe. I'm gonna look, you watch this. I won't even be recognized when I walk in there. No one's gonna know who I am.
We're here.
One plus one equals two.
We're here to fight the chaos of our reality.
Hi, hello.
Hello, sir. Do you wish life would be simpler?
Hi.
Would you like a pamphlet? Mike, come here. Mike, come on. Let's get it.
I have come in from ports. I am a man of the sea. I smell like brine, and I am interested in some social clubs.
Well, then you've come to the right two people to talk to.
Wow. We're happy to have you. If you're willing. You know, you take that pamphlet, you read up on us. We're here, basically our whole thing is to provide an answer for the chaos in the world. We believe everything's divisible by two and you can find peace and harmony that way.
Oh, very cool. How about, before you, I tell you some things about myself. That sounds fun, doesn't it?
Well, we are looking for potentially a new member.
Oh, you are?
Yeah, there's a hat ceremony later.
How about any room for briny sea dogs such as myself? Well,
the universe size.
Yeah, the duoverse. You can.
Sorry.
It's all right, Mike. This is Mike. We have a lot of options. You know, just check out the pamphlet. Check out what we're all about. You know.
I used to sail two ships, and I was lost at sea.
And it'll do that, you know, brother. The seeking, the journey for peace and harmony in this world often comes up against such hardship that people don't understand. That's what we're all about. We're all about facing the hardship. We are the community we're so excited to see a new face around.
Very cool.
So if you wanna check out that pamphlet, and we're so excited to have you come by later.
And what's your name? I'm Mike.
I'm Pete Calmasis.
Sailor ship,
nice.
You seem a little nervous. Are you nervous?
Oh, I'm not nervous. Thank you so much.
1 + 1 does not equal 2. Sometimes it equals like 2.5.
Did you like a pamphlet?
Because you can trade in your Wendy's points for like 2.5.
You know, for 10 years,
10 years he's been calling me, asking me about the Cult of Two and him trying to infiltrate the Cult of Two. And I said, it's been taking you 10 years. I could have knocked on their door and just walked right in.
Yes, my name is Bobby, Bobby Hyman, and I am shopping for some ingredients for a pie. I am a baker, and I look after children, and I, you know, I chauffeur them to and from the school parking lot, and then they go off to class, and yeah, and then I go home and I bake until I have to go and pick them back up. Now, if those people had been passing me flyers, you know, for like a cult for a marriage that, you know, is just a long, long, long journey of a, you know, kind of tumultuous, unhappy marriage that is a little rocky of an ending, you know, that I'd be interested in.
Can we address the elephant in the room here?
Oh, of course.
That's a cool haircut.
Thank you.
Pretty good. Today's a pretty big recruiting day for us. A lot of volume of people, a lot of handing out of flyers.
Hey, Mike! What's going on, guys?
Hey, do you want to...
We don't know you. No. I don't know who you are.
Yeah, you know me.
No, you know me. We don't. Hey. Can we call security or something?
Hey, wish life was simpler?
We don't have to... No. They,
here. Look at me in the eyes. I check.
I don't know. Yeah. Hi. Do you wish life were simpler?
Yeah.
Would you like to be...
simpler.
Can we have that back?
Peter, who is this?
Hey, this is nobody. I don't know.
No, I'm somebody. I'm Francine. I'm his sister.
Get the fuck out of here.
What are you talking about?
Get out of here. Get off me. Get off me. Get the fuck off me. Get the fuck off me.
What are they doing?
Two hats, two bras, no underwear.
You can wear underwear. I asked.
We're not asking you to not wear underwear.
That's just a me thing. That's just a me thing.
How do you feel, Mike?
I just wish life was simpler.
My name is Francine Kalnassus, and my mornings are peaceful. I do have one of those eye masks that have eyeballs on them that are shut. I think those things are so goofy. They are goofy, and I love them. Something I'm proud of. I cheered someone on at a marathon. So the connections that I have with people, I remember I talked with a man in a tunnel with a little hat on, and we talked about how we loved watching trains go by. Very, very, most people would overlook that. I know it practically feels like we're strangers, but I think I know each one of you extremely intimately. And also I have a stepsister, Stacy. She's cool.
Francine, oh gosh, she's just so wonderful. Always, always there for me. Her smile just lights up a room. She means everything to me. And I'm in love with her. And I mean, I love her. No, that would be wrong. To have a crush on a stepsister. Do I have any interest in the Cult of Two? No, not really.
Looks nice. This Yu-Gi-Oh card looks like something that I could take to a pawn shop. I have no money.
Do you know about Peter and the cult?
Do I know about Peter and the cult? Yes, 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 I do know about Peter and the cult. How could I not know about Peter and his cult? I know about it because they meet here in my home, the home that we're all in. But yet I'm not in it. My home's in it. How is my home in the cult before I'm in the cult?
I didn't understand that she was a part of the documentary.
Yes! They are using my home. I have nest cams. I have nest cams and nanny cams. Two words.
Nanny Cam.
Difficult to talk about her because I haven't spoken to her in years. I want nothing to do with her. I don't even know where she lives. I don't know where she gets her mail or like what kind of food she eats.
That's interesting because we talked to Francine and she says that you kind of stole her apartment 2 years ago for the ritual.
I don't, what does that mean? Steal someone's apartment? Would I take it out of the building and run away with it? It's not, how would I even get in? The back door is locked from 5 to 7.
You said you knew her PIN.
Oh, that place.
Absolutely without my permission. Peter knows that I would say no. And so what does Peter do? Peter exploits me. Exploits everything that I love. And you know how he does that? He has watched me. I know he has. I know he has. I have a feeling. It's like a sixth sense. Except that movie was piss.
It was a completely random act of breaking and entering. I didn't realize until after the fact that my sister lived there because I don't know where she lives. Now I do. I like the bay windows.
Wait. You just broke into a house not knowing who lived there?
I didn't break in. I need the pin.
You said it was a random act of breaking and entering.
Just stop cutting me off.
You feel like something's wrong with you, and I know nothing's wrong with me. It's Peter who doesn't like me. And it's not fair. I could do better. I've seen it. His rules. They're frivolous. They're silly. He just wants to tell people, no, you can't be here. No, you can't be here. No, you can't be here. I would be the exact opposite. I would say, you come. You come. You want to build community. And then I would push him out. Because sometimes you have to treat people how they want to be treated. Ipso facto, Peter's excluding so many people, he probably wants to be excluded, so I guess I'm doing him a favor, aren't I?
Is that what she says, that I excluded her? I guess if I was to really look hard at our childhood, I could see instances where maybe I sabotaged a relationship or two. Or maybe I, cut up all the invites to her birthday party before they made it out to the mailbox or like whatever.
Well, Pete's my best friend. But Francine's like a sister to me in a way, right? If I had to pick someone's side, Deborah's. She was like my second mom.
I am an instrument. I'm a tool in the handiwork of the universe, the duoverse. So it's not my fault or anyone's fault but her own that she's not been picked to be a part of this. So for her to kind of project that onto me, project that I'm not othering her, I'm not alienating anybody. It's a very inclusive organization of people. So I don't think that's not my fault.
So when Pete was 13, he got a paintball gun. My mom, there's no way that I was going to get something that cool. But I had a really nice helmet. And Pete had just seen Deer Hunter. He wanted to do the scene.
And that's a fond memory?
It hurts so bad, but he was laughing. He like cried. He nearly passed out. We almost had to call an ambulance just for him. And just to see that much joy.
Breaking and enduring, amongst some other things you have said, could be considered crimes. In your religion, where does morality come into play? Good.
I'm in a cult. I'm in a cult. I'm proudly in a cult. Why? What are the rules of society to a cult? I didn't join this. I didn't become the leader of this to
to obey rules that were given to me, like to inherit the societal expectation. If I want to break into someone's house, if I've been sent that message, if my body vibrates with the radiation of the voice of the over one, I'm not, who am I to say no to that, you know? Because a group of people got together and decided that that's illegal, you know, traumatizing and, you know, assault and battery and all these things that got leveled my way. It's not.
Are you a good guy?
Am I a good guy? Yeah.
Yes. That's what I want more than anything, is to be a part of the cult. It's community. And it's community that's happening currently with me and without me. And that's all I want, is to be a part of the community. To be a part of something. And all Peter wants, and what Peter likes, isn't the cult. Peter doesn't like the cult. Peter likes excluding me from the cult.
Can you say one nice thing about Francine?
She finally cut her hair.
She would always bat third and I'd bat fourth, so she was just like a power hitter and I was in the cleanup, and we were like the dynamic duo. And we had like this handshake and everything, which was basically just like the chicken dance. And like,
this is the day of the ritual. Happens once every 2 years.
Dose.
Yeah.
The ritual is a highly choreographed sequence of communal-based events.
So basically, the theme this year, Mike picked, it's a fruit party.
Fruit is so good tasting, and it's good for you.
There's gonna be decorations, you know. Mike's in charge of that this year. He's gonna bring a little something he's been working on. He hasn't told me though. I think it's, I think he's doing like a. What do you call it? Garland? I think he's doing garland.
Apples?
These are nectarines.
It's going to be good. But it's a really kind of well-decorated, extravagant, a ball almost?
No.
It's one candle.
Yeah, but it's two.
Yeah, it's the number two. Two ones made it then.
That would have been 11.
He only sees like the big picture, you know? He has, like, a master plan to it all, and, like, you just kind of follow those people. Yeah. He makes sure that I know that I need to, like, follow him.
Okay, I think it's time to get started, Mike. All right, you're
excited. I'm not good enough.
No, you're good enough. Just, don't, well, that might be on you, man. I don't know. I've been doing this for a long time, and I think I've got it. So today we are here to honor the spirit of two in the duo verse.
And you're all in my apartment.
Stop.
Thank you.
Thank you, Francine.
No.
Thank you.
Thank you, Francine.
Stop.
I'm a really horny guy. I'm not looking for love. and I heard that someone's getting kicked out, and I thought, hey, that's perfect, because I don't want any competition, and I've been getting a lot of competition lately in the sack.
I have very few human friends. I feel as though my birds are kind of my outlet to a social life, to kind of a sexual life as well. I feel as though if I'm around other humans and other people, and we could kind of talk about other things, you know, maybe how cool birds are, you know, other people like them too. It's really cool. Then maybe we can, form a connection and I could, get married and, yeah.
Did you say birds are connected to your sexual life?
Next question, please.
I've been coming here for a while now, every so often for these little drawings, and I'm just really hoping it's my year, you know?
What would be your perfect cult? Like, what's the biggest cult you really
want? Sex cult?
Not everyone is trying to have sex in every cult. We wouldn't want that, It's not always about sex. I mean, if you get down to it, life is sex, but your cult doesn't have to be about sex. You can be about sacrificing things and having sex.
A change, newness, something a little different, because I do teach children every single day. I have to talk down to them a lot. My favorite kid in the class, his name is Tom, and I like him because he's sort of almost an adult. I don't like children. Tom is somebody who I will defend until the death, and he's gotten in a lot of trouble at school. He does really bad things. He's got a bit of an arson problem. At one point he went on the speaker, the intercom, the journalist, the intercom, and he told all children that, and this is bad, that they should kill each other. But I swear to God, his smile just lights up a room. So I hope that answers your question.
We will now pass out the sacred pens. Please write upon the papers presented to you your names so that they may be thrown in the sacred hat. So that the duoverse may determine who the next members are and who is leaving.
I will walk around with the hat. Brother Pete will walk around.
And we'll begin here.
I'll take one, just one.
I'm gonna pass them out individually. Thank you.
This is a really cool part of the ceremony where people write their names on a piece of paper, and then we're gonna decide. Well, the duoverse decides who gets to be in the cult.
Right, how many pens are in play? Who's got the third pen?
What?
Who's got the third pen?
I have a third
Sharpie.
Here. I'm not
full. Twice.
Get two pens. Two pens.
Well, one pen and one Sharpie. No.
Ten.
Right. Sorry. You gotta fold it twice.
But you wrote that down. I didn't finish.
Fold it twice.
Just whatever your name is, just put it on the paper.
Are you? Do you want to enter in?
Please don't rush me.
No.
I'm so sorry.
Piece of paper. That you want. Okay, what? What?
Can I write my name now?
Yeah, write your name.
Sorry.
10 years? Are you kidding me? What an idiot.
You might not see it, but the symmetry with which I've practiced the penmanship of my name does equal up to two. And it's just the little rituals that I do to make sure I get picked again.
It is the burning of the old and the incoming of the new. It is possible that both of us could leave the cult today. I have been picked 5 ceremonies in a row. And now it is time for the sacrificial slice.
Go.
We bring out the sword
And people get a little tense during that part. Transcendence, you know, and that's very important to the human experience. And there's also a mingle period after.
Sure. So the sword, it was just, I'm not going to pull it out. Okay. It's just a cake. Here, so here. We're going to use a regular kitchen
knife.
Divine.
Divine.
Shut up. Shut up.
Just say divine.
Shut up.
They get scared. You have a knife.
There's no knife.
I don't have. Okay, look, just shut up. Chocolate. Mike made it himself. Brother Mike made double chocolate cake.
It looks like vanilla.
It's vanilla.
It's vanilla.
Francine, shut up.
It's double chocolate cake.
After all the physical metaphors and the things are choreographed and explained and performed and done and eaten, I pull out the names and the future is in that moment decided.
And the first name to be chosen for this generation of the Cult of Two is...
I think the rightful leader will be chosen. That's who I think. I think someone who can step up and take the cult in a new direction will be chosen. That's who I think will be chosen. I think it might be me.
I think it's going to be me and Mike again. I don't. But you never know. You never know. Right? So.
I hope so. It's my best friend's in it. I mean, I don't. Can Pete not be in it? I don't even know if that's possible. But, like, yeah, it'd be cool. It's just nice to, like, be special.
And now open your eyes.
You didn't tell us to close.
It's Mike.
Fuck!
Brother Mike, another generation.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Brother Mike. A round of applause for Brother Mike and the new generation.
And the fun part about this is you put it in your bulletin board in your room.
I scrapbook mine. I have five.
Okay. Five bulletin boards or five?
Six.
I don't have five bulletin boards. And the next name to be pulled from the hat.
Me.
Who is it, Pete?
So, it's Francine.
Fuck! Fuck! Fuck!
Francine.
Okay. Okay. Wow. I guess, cult of two right here. Let's keep hitting some sprites. Yeah. Thank you. I guess I should put it on.
Pete, do you want your dinosaur?
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh, it looks great on you.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know. Feels different, you know?
Yeah. New leaf. Blank slate.
Blank slates, because there's got to be two.
Yeah.
I think what's going to make us successful in this cohort of twos is really making sure that the other person's seen.
Yeah. You know, sometimes I feel like some people's stories don't get heard.
Yeah. I get that.
How would I feel if I didn't get picked? I would trust that the duo has a bigger purpose for me. Right? If someone has their own ideas, that's okay. But when you...
That's really funny.
Community means more than one person. But...
Francine is now in the cult. What can you tell me about it?
We're all alone and we're all gonna die. But, you know, there are some sunny things. The sun, for example, is great.
He said you should come to this meeting. Check us out on meetup.com. At the time, I only had dial-up, though, so we didn't.
She's in this cult where I'm not allowed to come.
It's a thing. Okay, so, right?
Francine, stop.
People take shits. Everybody does. Sorry.
Yeah. Glad we said.
What's up with that?
I actually grew this from a sapling. I got a seed from my wife as a gift. I don't have children of my own. I can't have children. And if I could, I wouldn't want to.
And now we dunk. Yeah. Yeah, it's freaking awful, personally, on me. Because I don't get the rules of it. She just comes home and says, well, sorry, I went to a meeting today. You can't fucking come.
It's like a sixth sense, except that movie was piss. Sorry.
Did you think that? Pretty much my idea of cult is like having three or four of like my greatest friends in the world be allowed to come over to my house without getting yelled at.
Normally she'll put me in one of those wagons and...
Pete and Jesse Deer Hunter. so stupid.
You were the chosen one! You were supposed to bring balance to the Force! I hate you! I hate you! You were like a brother to me! I loved you!
It's just so intense.
And you see yourself as Darth Vader?
Yeah.